fishing pressure is too high. It's above the scientific advice. At the moment, the stocks have been able to withstand that, but there is always the danger that won't continue, and the ultimate outcome can be stock collapse. What's needed is an agreement amongst the coastal states and the fishing states to agree on quota shares so that the total allowable catch is adhered to in the actual catches that are taken from the fishery. The science and data are important. They're important for stock assessment and sustainable management. But when it comes to the quota sharing agreements, ultimately it's a political decision.
I would expect that climate change, the way it is continuing now, is going to affect the distribution of fish species much more in the future. So it is really important to find mechanisms at the policy level of how you share these resources. What needs to happen in the Northeast Atlantic is finding a way of achieving an agreement between coastal states. And currently we don't have a mechanism in the science to provide information on spatial distribution and changes therein. I think there should be much more focus in the scientific domain to inform policymakers on what is happening in the oceans. But in the end, it is an agreement that policymakers need to achieve. It's not a scientific question how you share the resources.
Yes, small pelagics are changing all throughout Europe. Anchovy and sardine, they've become smaller, they've become thinner, they've become skinny. And all this is reflecting the underlying change in ecosystems. And these changes are happening now. They are not end of a century projections. It's real life, it's now.
The pelagic fisheries we talk about here, mackerel, blue whiting, and herring, has for centuries been moving, right? They don't stay in one place. So the question is, who owns this fish? And the way it is now is that one country says, I'm going to fish this much, and another one says, I'm going to fish this much, and the sum is more than 100%. That's why you have overfishing. My message to the coastal state is that please understand that the biggest buyers from blue whiting are saying, if this FIP fails, we will all walk away and we will stop purchasing blue whiting, period. Sit down, get an agreement, so we can still source this fantastic sustainable product, which blue whiting is.
Sustainable fisheries, it's super important. That's a short answer. If everybody is acting on its own without cooperation, in the end, all the parties will lose more than they win individually. If we are not able to cooperate, and if we are not able to make agreements, in the end, we all lose.